What's up, guys? We're gonna continue the remasters, and we are now starting on the fortress themes. So let's see what's going on here. So we have that brass synth, then that brass synth is going to have a delay. Yeah, it should have a delay. Yeah, so let's start with start our brass pattern here. And let's see, this delay does not have any I mean, this doesn't have any. No, so it's just gonna be a straight stereo delay. But we have to get the patch first. Maybe we'll keep the chorus on it. Brass synth. So, okay, so let's go to mix a track. Thank you. Maybe not too much of a delay. Too much of exciter. There we go. That's sounding pretty good. Ba 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 ba. So we have strings in the guitar, and it's gonna have delay, of course. Maybe not a delay because they're two separate they have two separate pitches. Let this start playing. So, There's Renato. Yeah, the orchestra hits in Sigma Battle 2 have this delay on them, and the delay is different to the one in Launch Octopus. But as for the abrupt ending, I'm gonna have to maybe adjust the release on them. See how it sounds. But we'll get back to that. I just wanna, get through the fortress stuff. Okay, what were we? Is that guitar? Actually, we're gonna go ahead and do this one first. So, all right, so no, we want our strings. Why did I choose the bass? There we go. Oh, and fun fact, the string chords on this song. You know that the very four notes like this one. Yeah, these chords right here. I'm sorry, not chords, notes. These notes are actually the very same notes at the beginning of "In the Air Tonight" by Phil Collins. Those same by Phil Collins, those same chord pads, those notes, those four notes right there. And yeah, I thought that was pretty interesting. Give it a mixer track. Let's see, does this have the same padding? to the left, that's 30% to the left. So if this has the same panning, then we can use the same instance. Yeah, we can go ahead and copy over then these, since the pannings are the same. Okay. Oh, and it crashed. Yeah, I like how that sounds. So now we're going to copy the guitar. Song 2 had a song with strings that had a similar melody. Can you send that? I want to hear that. Ba, ba. See if it's the same pitch. Just needs an envelope added to it. Okay, sounds pretty good. Let's give this a mixer track and copy the other guitar notes. Yeah, that's the right pitch. That sounds good. I like that. But I want to give it some, add that chorus to it to give it that, we want that spread out feel to it. Yeah, I like that preset. Now let's give it that panning. Wait, does it have a vibrato effect? Let's see. It does have a vibrato effect. But let's see if it. Amount too much. Okay, yeah, that sounds good. Sam Raw. Sam's like the Gordon Ramsay of music, basically. Okay, so guitar sounds good, but I want to kind of like it has those highs. Let me get rid of some of the lows here. Yeah, that sounds good. Okay, save it. Okay, so we have some cymbal stuff going on here. Where's my M1? There we go. But we have to, let's give it some a little bit, a tiny bit of release, not too much, just a tiny bit. Like, just a hair. No, not even a hair. But like a pinch. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, we can't give it too much more, really, because it's a very short sample. Interesting. We're using your networking to restore compressed audio. Is that'd be dope. We're not to white noise. I don't know any noise. Okay, so wanna add some chorus to this. Not too much chorus. There we go. I like volume automation on here. Wait, there's volume automation. Wait, is it like is it rushing or dragging? Wait a minute. Yeah. The crashes are dragging. No, crashes are rushing. Pulled another name again. I pulled another name again. There we go. Can I think this is the snare? No, the kick. So, got the kick. Okay, we have these other type of brass stabs. Okay, so this has echo notes. We have to get into the good habit of using our own delay, just like how Sam does. Two, and we're gonna put it in the brass pattern. Give it our own mixer track. There we go. Yeah, I like that. Okay. Okay, we're gonna take that tom. Ba 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 ba. There All right. Now those snares. Okay, so, and I know it has it's gonna have a delay somewhere. Okay. All right, well, just, yeah, I think that sounds pretty good, so. And on that snare, we have to put that chorus. And then saturate it. There we go. I think this is the another crash. Yeah. Gonna go ahead and bust it into Oh, we forgot to reset the delay. Oh, we forgot to, yeah. All right. Okay, so we got the crash. And we just got the bass left. And the bass one needs to be quite hearable because that's how it was in the original. And I believe that's it, so we can now put it all together. Ooh. Something's rushing. Yep, sorry about that. Big oof. There we go. Wait a minute, why is the is the timing not resetting? Let me make a loop so it doesn't sound all awkward. So why is it not slicing? see what you guys are saying. Yeah, because the snare actually had a delay effect on it in the original, so I just deleted the echo notes and yeah. It sounds okay now. There we go. See, it's not resetting the delay has the delay plugin kind of has a little bug where it doesn't reset the state for some weird reason. Even though the automation is at zero, it's still, I don't know why it's, when I start the song over again, it's not resetting to that point. Just weird. See, like I have automation, but it's not resetting back to zero when I start the thing over again. Same with the, yeah, same with this one. So I don't know. I think it's like a bug, because it's supposed to reset. Yeah, something's weird with the automation. I don't know why it's not working right. See, I have the event pattern right here. Works now. Yeah, I don't know why it won't. Sometimes it won't just work on the pattern itself. It's just odd. But oh well. All right. So I'm gonna do that loop real quick and the fade out. All right, everything sounds pretty good. The bass is here, is hearable. I don't know, Renato, what do you think about the bass? Have to give it a little boost, or jazz is. Let me listen to the original. All right, well, it sounds pretty good, so let me go get a drink and I'll come back and add some TSR. The basic fundamentals of reverb. Number one, TSR. Number two, TSR. And number three, more TSR. All right, y'all, back. So, to add some TSR. Set it to our okay, so in our bass, we don't need to give it any reverb. Thank you. Think it's done, y'all. Let's see if anybody else has any objections. I'll keep it running. See, was there an extra crash symbol? Yes, there's two crash symbol types. Alright, yeah, sounding pretty good, so let me go ahead and export these. Now the burning question. Where did Sam go? Not sure what you mean by volume tweaking, the length of the delay, or you just mean the actual volume of the snare?
Thank you.
believe that was in the original, that symbol. Yeah, that was there. Oh, that wasn't there in the ring. Okay, let's see. Weird. Okay, that started at 9. It's probably rushing somehow. Yeah. It was rushing, Neiman. Why isn't the that snare, that event not resetting? Why is the plugin not working right? Me reset it. Yeah, it's supposed to reset the events, but it's not doing it. See, it's supposed to, the automation's supposed to reset at 0 right here, but it keeps on keeping the same automation right from right here. And what is Renato saying about the that volume? I think you mean the, do you mean how long the delay is? Let's see.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think it sounds pretty good now. Oh, there's supposed to be like a third echo note in there. Okay, so. I think that's sounding good now. See what to say now, Renato. Yeah, I think it's starting to shape up now. See what we're saying. Not sure if we could do really do anything about the actual volume. Let's see here. No, we can't really do anything about the actual volume because I think in the SPC, even though the volumes were like similar, it was trying to duplicate delay. It was an actual delay. It was just trying to duplicate it by adding notes, and that's why the velocities were the same. But since we're actually using a reverb plugin, I mean a delay plugin, then it's quite different. So I don't know. I don't think we can really increase the actual volume of the echo notes that much, and we would have to increase the timing, but then that would, put everything off. That would, So yeah. Yeah, I think it's pretty much good the way it is now. Looking pretty good. Yep, think it's done, y'all. And gonna take a break and then gonna come back. Hopefully I get time tonight and come back and we're gonna do the other fortress themes. Sigma Fortress 2 was like another hard one. Especially with the guitar, but now since we're not using contact, we're using the raw wave, guitar wave, then it's gonna be, I think it's gonna be much more easier. Much easier. And that track is still pretty raw. Not as raw as Boomer, but All right, so.